How do you make the most efficient use of your time on the GK math test? Hi, I'm Anderson, Math Director of the Learning Liaisons, and in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to use the formatting of the test to your advantage. That way, you can curb that test anxiety and pass your next attempt. Stay tuned, let's get cracking. So how do you make the most efficient use of your time? Biggest question you could ask. And the thing is, the answer is actually very simple. The formatting of the test, it goes like this. There are four competencies: number and quantity, geometry and measurement, algebra and functions, and statistics and probability. And what you may not have known is that the test actually appears in that exact order too. So the first seven questions are going to be competency one. The next set of eight questions are going to be competency two. The next set of 12 will be competency three. And the last set of 13 are going to be competency four. So let's go ahead and list that out one more time. So questions 1 through 7, that's going to be competency 1. Competency 2, that's going to be questions 8 through 15. Competency 3, questions 16 to 27. And competency 4, 28 to 40. So the next time you take your test, now you know exactly where each of these competency questions are going to appear. And the reason that makes so much sense in terms of knowing this information is because you can apply it now to only begin with the questions you know how to answer. So for example, let's say you hate geometry, which a lot of people do. Those rate problems and volume problems, they get nasty, right? So let's say you like algebra instead. Let's say you're good at those, you know, equations and solving them and functions and slope. Let's say you like those. You prefer those much to geometry. Well, that's competency three. And that means you're going straight to questions 16 to 27. Those are the 12 questions that you're going to have for competency three. So do you see how this is making sense? This is the best thing that you could have ever run into in terms of curbing that test anxiety, because you don't have to swim anymore. If you've watched any of our previous videos, you know how swimming can kill you on this test, because you're timed. And so there's no point in going through the test question 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, all the way through. There's no point in doing that. You want to start off with the questions that you know how to answer. That way, you can build your confidence immediately, knowing how many you've gotten right, and then circle back around to those tougher questions. Because there's nothing worse than starting a test on that first question. Yeah, it takes you maybe 2.5 minutes. The average amount of time on the test is 2 minutes and 15 seconds per question. But let's say, you know, the first question, yeah, 2 minutes, okay. Next question, cool, a minute. Then third question takes you like 4 or 5 minutes. Start getting nervous. Fourth question takes you about 4 minutes. Fifth question, 5 minutes. And you see how that snowball effect just turns into anxiety, hopelessness, confusion, all that scary feelings that you're going to have in your head going through this test. It does not have to be that way. And the reason is because now you know where these test questions are going to be. So in those competencies, they're not going to order the skills they're in. Perhaps those questions are going to be mixed up in terms of that one competency, but nonetheless, everything competency one is going to be right at the beginning of the test. You know, you may see skill one at the end of competency one versus at the beginning, and that's quite all right. But the fact of the matter is, you know exactly where to find those competency questions. And so I want you to be smarter every day and use this information to pass on your next attempt. So from the Learning Liaisons, I'm Anderson. And remember, it's when you pass, not if you pass. Don't shy away from giving this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you like this video to keep up with more. Let's get cracking. We'll see you next time.